start.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. A little tired. I drove up from the south of France 4 days ago, and I've done 700 miles in 3 days. And I drove up from Dover last night, so I'm a bit spaced out, a bit tired.
Are you sure?
Definitely.
Tell us about it. You came second in Eurovision,
yeah.
With a partner.
With a partner. Singing partner.
Yeah, but he was billed as your brother, right?
Only in the sense that we, as a name for the act, I had invented the name Allison as a good name for the act. And it was just common practice at the time. If the group was singing together, they called themselves the Brothers. So we became the Allison Brothers, not intending to fool anybody or take advantage of them. It was just the name of the act. And we suddenly realised people thought we were brothers. And then we got frightened and we didn't dare tell them we weren't, because we thought they might say, oh, we're not going to make a record then. So we kept it quiet to the last moment. And it happened by accident, the revelation happened by accident. The press sent a report around to my house. My dad, who was a bit old-fashioned, he'd been in the army and so on, and he was very stickler for doing things properly. And he opened the door and the reporter said, oh, are you the father of the brothers? And my father said, they're not brothers, they're just friends. And the bloke said, oh, we're you know, and we were in France singing in the final. And my mother, so my family didn't have a television. It was a luxury goods then. So my mum had gone round to my partner's house and he's watching it with his mum.
But you have seen your performance since then?
No.
You haven't seen your 1961 performance?
Oh, on the final of the Eurovision,
yeah.
Yes. But the BBC threw away our BBC heat. Can you believe it? And we became the first act ever to do two encores. At the end of the evening, when we won the British heat, we had to go back on and sing it again. We finished and the studio erupted in excitement. We went to go off stage and Katie Boyle said to us, you're going to have to do it again. So we became the first, and as far as I know, the only act ever to do two encores.
Amazing.
And just if my father had seen it.
No, of course not. But of course, just to tell our readers, in 1961, United Kingdom got the second position,
yes.
Thanks to Mr. John Allison.
I'd written the song 2 years before. I'd never heard of the Eurovision. It was just one of a whole string of songs.
Do you watch it, the Eurovision today?
Sometimes, not every time. It's very big and long now, and it goes on forever. And your eyes begin to ache.
But what do you think?
I think the voting's funny.
You came second. I mean, do you think United Kingdom would ever sort of hit those?
Oh, yes. They haven't given me another chance.
Would you do it again?
Oh, yeah, I'd love to do it. I'd do something with a rock and roll beat and a catchy tune. I'd love to do it.
You would do Eurovision again?
Yeah, I'd love to. I'm a ham.
Amazing. Well, thank you very much. This is Wiwibloggs.com. We've got Mr. John Allison.
But if I get enough support, I mean, I can do an online petition.
And you can have another encore.
I want to do another encore.
United Kingdom 1961. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Nice talking.